In this video, we will understand about app.component.ts. Components are the basic building blocks of an Angular application. When the Angular workspace was created, a single default component is created, which is the app component. This is the root component of the Angular application, and all other components will become the child components of the app component. We can create as many components as we want based on the need of the application. Each component consists of an HTML template, a TypeScript class, and a CSS stylesheet. The HTML template is what will be visible in the browser. In case of app component, this is represented in the file app.component.html. The TypeScript class helps to handle the events that will happen on the component. For example, when user clicks on a button, an event is triggered and the TypeScript component class will contain the code to handle the event. In case of app component, the TypeScript class is represented in the file app.component.ts. The CSS stylesheet helps to define component-specific styles. In case of app component, the stylesheet is represented in the file app.component.css. The @componentDecorator helps to define additional information for the app component class. We will look into the @componentDecorator in app.component.ts. The template URL property helps to define the HTML template. The TypeScript class is defined as a class attached to the component decorator. The CSS stylesheet is applied using style URLs property. We can see how @componentDecorator brings together the HTML template, TypeScript class, and CSS styles. Now let us look into app.component.ts in Visual Studio Code. The component decorator class is part of the Angular built-in library. We can see that this is imported from @angular/core. If I expand node modules folder, we can see the @angular folder, and when I expand that, we can see the core folder. When we created the Angular workspace, hope you remember, it took quite some time to create the Angular workspace. The reason for the delay is due to the download of built-in libraries of Angular into node_modules folder from internet. All the built-in libraries of Angular are present in the node_modules folder. Under the core folder, we can see only one TS file, which is core.d.ts. Let me open this TS file. Let me go to line 875. We can see the component class defined here, which is what we are importing and using it as a decorator in app.component.ts. The explanation so far would have helped you understand the significance of app.component.ts. Now we will look into the naming convention followed by Angular for defining file names and class names. The file name should be defined in all lowercase and words separated by a period. App is one word, component is another word, hence it is separated by a period. Class name is defined with each word's first letter capitalized. We can see A in app and C in component capitalized. This naming convention is not specific to component, but in general for Angular. Hope this explanation clarifies all questions related to app.component.ts. In the next video, we will understand about app.module.ts.